Welcome to the Phantom Xtraordinaire. This is no ordinary show. Here, some of Nigeria's boldest and most extraordinary people will grace our screens and spill their secrets. They are some of the best in their industries, visionaries and pioneers, charting new courses that many have followed and continue to follow. Now join us as they tell their truths and choose their dreams. It will be inspiring. It will be daring. It will have you in your feels and at the edge of your seat. It will be fun. Come, let's go on this bold ride together. Welcome to today's episode of the Phantom Extraordinaire called The Bold Influence. Today's guest is special. This is a man that inspires and motivates many across the globe. And beyond actually talking, he actually puts his action where his mouth is. He's the president of a non-profit, non-governmental organization focused on training youth for transformational leadership and social change. One of his notable projects is the Mushi Makeover. This man was able to get 2,000 people on the streets of Lagos, painting 296 houses across 7 streets, all for free. And beyond that, in 2019, he was also a presidential candidate, showing that this man does not only believe in a better Nigeria, he's ready to commit and do the work in achieving this Nigeria we all dream of. Ladies and gentlemen, I bring to you the very bold and extraordinary Mr. Fela Durotoye.
Hey.
Or made you pay your call.
T, how you doing?
Nice to meet you. It's a pleasure. I thought I was going to, you know, you look so fresh, so dapper. Like your suit game is almost better than mine.
You know how they say it. You know how they say it. Fine, you dress wine. The way you want to be addressed, bro.
Liners. I knew I'll be taking those today. All right, Mr. Fela, I was looking a bit into your background and, you know, something struck me, and I'm like, he was raised by one parent. And I know that definitely changed or influenced the dynamics of your life. Can you tell me about that?
Well, I was born to a couple. My parents were lecturers, first in University of Ibadan.
Both parents?
And both parents. And then they moved to University of Ife at that time. And my father, the late professor, you know, talking about Durotoye, became the youngest professor in Nigeria at that time in 1975, at the age of 36. My mother became a professor of quaternary geology, the only female professor of quaternary geology in Africa.
Oh, wow.
However, when I was 11 years old, my father died suddenly. And so my mom had to raise three children. I was the third of those three children. Oh, so yeah. I was 11, my brother was 14 and my sister was 13. My sister was 14, my brother was 15. Okay. And to cut the long story short, you know, they were just about to go into uni.
And that happened.
But I think that the thing that I learned the most just watching my mom was two things, right? Number one, I got to discover the husband of the widow. That God actually shows up, because in my home, I mean, remember, my lecturers are not rich. They're not, but somehow there was never anything missing in my home.
You didn't lack.
We never lacked. And my mom had to learn all the skills that they must have taught her in home economics, how to reuse matchsticks and all of those kind of
so
things.
So this
and you know, and then the other thing is that we are, my siblings, all people with social skills. So we always had friends in our home. Our home, people were always eating, but there was never a day that my mom said there was no food. So I learned, number one, about the provider, the one who provides for the widow. The second thing that I learned was that women are strong.
Very.
And I learned to respect strong women. When Tara and I were going to get married, Tara had just started her business, a makeup business, but then we'd done quite a bit of work. You see, I was a management consultant, you know, she's an entrepreneur.
Two different
So, you know, but I was doing a lot of whatever we could to push the brand out there. But I remember that when we were going to get married, an elderly woman, you know, who was pretty close to the family, called me and said, Fela, you know what? You know, if you want your wife to listen to you, kill her business.
Ah.
I'm telling you. Auntie.
Auntie, kill her.
And she said it in Yoruba. if you don't kill her business, she will not listen to you. So I looked at her and I said, auntie, I understand. I said, auntie, you think that, you know, you're looking at me for where I am. I said, you don't know where I'm going. I said, auntie, if you understand where I'm going and the vision that I have, there is no success that Tara can ever have that will not be able to fit into it. She said, okay. The scriptures say that the woman is the crown on her husband's head. The more successful she is, the greater the jewels. The greater the jewels, the badder I am. You understand?
The better
so I'm a badder king when my wife is a successful bejeweled crown.
To your background, still you had a very, well, okay, not like you were poor, but you had a humble background, humble beginnings. Tell me about that journey.
Well, so I always say to people that, you know, when I got married to Tara, we were in what you call a one-bedroom room. one-bedroom room, because it's a boys' quarter in the block, and most of your neighbors are cooks and drivers and nannies and, you know. And I, you know, it's your one room, and then you have a collective bathroom collective toilet. If you go to the toilet, you don't know what you meet there. You have to take turns. I mean, it's not like you stand outside to go to the bathroom, but you have to listen out to say, is there somebody in the bathroom before you go? And more importantly, I mean, at one time for the first maybe 2 months or so, you know, Tara literally used to have to go back to her house to go and, you know. Oof. But one day I had asked Tara, I said, you know, baby, you're insane. She said, why would you say that? I said, even me, I would not have married me. What did you see? And she said two things to me, Toby, that blew my mind. She said, every time you opened your mouth, you would paint pictures of where we were going, and I had to be there. And she said, then your values, my experience with you told me that the journey will be sweet.
Two terms of it, sir, you are a major influencer. You know, I heard about the Mushi makeover. One man gets 2,000 people to paint 296 houses across 7 streets. How did you get people to move?
Well, I think that people are moved by vision, not just goals, and great vision have. So you know how it is. Again, don't tell me it's aspire to pass by. You see, they say your goals have to be smart, specific, measurable, achievable, realistic, and time-bound. Yes, but vision is more than that. And yet it also has to be smart. The one thing I'm just trying to say is, I think that Mushi Makeover, for me, showed the power of people when individuals decide to come and do something together.
So that planted something in you.
Oh yeah, because people came with just one brush. We asked people to come with their paint. And with your paint and with your brush, just all of us trying to do the same thing, guess what? We did what had never been done before.
Ever.
It was the largest urban renewal project that was non-governmental in Africa's history.
What was the defining moment and what struck in you and you're like, okay, you know what, I should have a foundation and Gemstone Foundation, you know, to build or to teach leadership, transformational leadership, I call it. You know, what was the idea behind that?
Well, so, you know, like they say, and there's an Igbo proverb, I've only heard about it. they say, when my neighbors are hungry, my chicken is not safe.
One for the books.
So it's important that we all do well, rather than I do better than everybody else. And that's what the whole idea of the Gemstone Nation Builders Foundation is.
Was that what made you run for presidency in 2019?
Absolutely. You know, and I think that more importantly, because it occurred to me that Nigeria is a blessed country. Blessed country is different from great nation. The greatness of a nation can only be done by the citizens of that nation. In a way, good people typically step back, whereas we should step forward to help build the great nation that we have. And so for me, all I wanted to do, and I kept on telling my team, I told everybody if they care to listen, I said, whether I win the election or not is not my goal. My goal is I have stepped forward so that other people can step in. My message was one and the same throughout the campaign.
Get involved.
And that was what I was. So when people come and say, oh, fella, you lost an election, I say, well, you don't know why I ran in the first place. I ran to get people involved.
So now let me get a bit of fun questions. I know you have a bucket list.
Yeah.
What is on your bucket list?
Okay, there are plenty of things. Some of that I can tell you, some of that I can't. Yeah. But I'll tell you one of them. I'll tell you one of the ones I want to do. You know, it is really skydiving.
I've done it before.
Ooh,
it's the best experience.
Tell me.
It's the most thrilling experience
ever. I'm telling you.
And the thing is, when you're up in the air, there is no part of you that won't ask yourself, what am I doing? And at the time you're about to jump from the plane, it's more like, and I was going to be cool on the plane. I was going to do, you know what, I'm the king of the world. But when the guy jumped, I'm like, ah! You should do that.
What did your parents say?
No, I did it after. I told them after.
So it's one of those things I've not told Tara, but now you people have leaked at me. You have leaked my secrets.
But she'll support you.
I'm sure.
She's letting you ride again.
Yeah.
I'm sure she'll get there. Ladies and gentlemen, like you know, selfie time. It's time for us to explore the beauty of this Phantom X.
Yay! Let's do it.
Whose suit is going to win this?
You're spanking.
It's you. Me, I'm new breed. Hey. Boss. So that now they know I'm not farming. I know we're together in this team.
Woo!
Boss, refresh.
Just want to be like
the light again. Okay, this time around is game time. My favorite segment. You have to go back on your seat while I explain this part to you, ladies and gentlemen. You know what time it is? It's game time, and let's see what Mr. Fela is going to be doing for us today. We have heard so many truths from Mr. Fela Durotoye. Now it is time for him to choose a dare. Each of this phone has a dare. Whichever you choose, you would have to perform the dare to the letter.
To the letter?
To the letter. Kindly choose your dare.
To the letter?
Yes.
See, my heart is doing boom, 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 boom. Can we do that thing we used to do when we were kids? Eeny, meeny, miny, moe. Let's see.
You see, his own is fresh. Me, I'm going to do tolo, tolo.
This one is on my side.
Okay, the one closer to you.
To the letter. I'm ready.
Are you sure?
I'm ready.
The other option, if you chose this phone, what you would have had to do is act like your wife for the rest of the show.
Oh, wow. Can I still choose it?
Here it says, and I read, you must race Tobi on a power bike. So now I've been involved in this game. You have to beat a time. You have to get on the bike, run the distance, and whoever gets there in the shortest time wins.
Oh, wow. I love this.
Good luck. Three, two, one.
I try.
You go. Good luck. Go.
Power
belongs to God.
No respect.
All power belongs to God.
Give honor to who honor is due.
Baba. Well, he's older than me. He has more experience than me. What did you guys expect? Shocked me. I didn't expect him to win. But then it's fine. You know, I'll be a good loser. So that's it for this episode.
But before I leave, here's a sneak peek of next week's action. Tara Durotoye.
To walk into Target, walk into Walmart, and see Tara in those stores.
I will not appear. Like,
I saw the way you kind of.
Yeah, I'm like,
ow!
It's game time.
No!
On the team. Now, don't forget to stay tuned for the next episode, but more importantly, stay bold and stay extraordinary.
Phantom X. New Elise flagship. Be bold. Be extraordinary.